Good morning, class one. I hope you are healthy and safe and you are enjoying all the online sessions given by us. You know what is going around you? Yes, I know you know about the virus. What is the name of the virus? COVID-19. But today, I'm going to tell you some more interesting facts about our country. Let us improve our general knowledge. But first let me tell you what is general knowledge. General knowledge is the general awareness about the things going on around us, like some current event or what is happening or about our country, whatever. So some general awareness. So now we are going to read a few questions and this will improve your general knowledge a lot. So first one, what is the name of our country? Do you know? I have told you, and then last time in one of the video, I had told you what is the name of our country? India. Then, what is the capital of our country? The capital of our country, the name of the capital of our country is New Delhi. Who? Now, question 3. Who is the president of India? Now, you know how to form the sentences. So, we are going to speak full sentences. The president of India is Mr. Ram Nath Kovind. Number 4. Who is the vice president of India? The vice president of India is Mr. Venkaiya Naidu. Who is the Prime Minister of India? And this I think everybody knows, right? The Prime Minister of India is Mr. Narendra Damodar Das Modi. Who is known as the father of our nation? I think this also everybody knows. Who is he? He is Mahatma Gandhi. So, in a complete sentence, how will we say? The father of our nation is Mahatma Gandhi. When do we celebrate Independence Day? So, we celebrate Independence Day in our school also, na? What is the date? It is 15th August. So, full sentence. We celebrate Independence Day on 15th August. When do we celebrate Republic Day? We celebrate Republic Day on 26th January. When do we celebrate Gandhi Jayanti? But tell me, when do we celebrate? We celebrate Gandhi Jayanti on 2nd October. And it is the birthday of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation. Now, name the national animal of India. Okay? Now, you are going to tell me which is the national animal of India? It is tiger. The national animal of India is tiger. Name the national bird of India. Have you seen that bird? It is a very beautiful bird. What is the name? Peacock. The national bird of India is peacock. Name the national fruit of India. It is a very yummy fruit. And I think everybody loves to eat it. It is of yellow color. What is the name of the fruit? Mango. So, the national fruit of India is mango. Name the national flower of India. The national flower of India is lotus. Name the national tree of India. The national tree of India is Indian banyan tree. Name the national aquatic animal of India. Now, who are aquatic animals? The animals which live in water are called aquatic animals. So, which is the national aquatic animal? It is river dolphin. So, the national aquatic animal of India is river dolphin. Name the national game of India. The national game of India is hockey. So, now once again, can we revise? Okay, randomly I'm going to ask a few questions. Who is the Prime Minister of our country? Mr. Narendra Damodar Das Modi. When do we celebrate Gandhi Jayanti? We celebrate Gandhi Jayanti on 2nd October and it is the birthday of our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. Which is the national fruit of our country? It is mango. So now, some other questions, okay? First question is, how many hours are there in a day? So you, when you have nothing to do, you feel very bored and you think that it's such a long day. So do you know how many hours are there in a day? There are 24 hours in a day. Then how many days are there in a year? How many days? You know, 365 days. There are 365 days in a year. How many days are there in a leap year? What is a leap year? A leap year is a year in which there is one extra day. So this year, that is 2020, is a leap year because there is one extra day. So how many days are there now? 366. So what will be our answer? There are 366 days in a leap year. Now, you know in which month the one extra day is added? In the month of February. Generally, February has how many days? 28 days. Now, the question is, how many days are there in the month of February in a leap year? So, I just told you that generally, February has how many days? 28 days. But in a leap year then, how many days it will be having? When one day will be added to it? Yes, 29 days. So, there are 29 days in the month of February in a leap year. Now, coming to our studies, back to the studies and the lessons. And today's topic is pronoun. The meaning of the word pro is instead of. And what are nouns? Nouns are the names of persons, places, animals or things. So, as it is clear from the literal meaning, pronouns are words used instead of a noun. Words such as I, you, me, we, us, they, them, he, she, it, him, her, etc. are pronouns. Now I'm going to tell you an incident. One day when Rohan reached his school, he was very happy. His teacher asked him, "What happened? Why are you smiling?" Rohan told the teacher that about his uncle. He said, "Uncle John is coming to stay with us for 4 days. Uncle John will bring many sweets and toys for me. Uncle John will take me for a picnic. Uncle John loves me a lot." The teacher said, "Oh, that's great, but you are making a mistake." Rohan was unable to understand. Then the teacher told him that instead of using the noun Uncle John so many times, we can use pronoun. Rohan said, "Pronouns? What is a pronoun?" The teacher explained, "Words used in place of nouns are called pronouns. So, instead of using Uncle John so many times, we are going to use the pronoun he." Now, coming back to what Rohan had said. He has said, "Uncle John is coming to stay with us for 4 days. Then again he had used the noun Uncle John. So instead of this Uncle John, we are going to use the pronoun he. Now what will be the sentence? He will bring many sweets and toys for me. Now again he had used Uncle John. So again we are going to use the pronoun he. He will take me for a picnic. He loves me a lot. Now the paragraph is sounding better. So we should always use a pronoun wherever necessary instead of a noun. He is used for males like your father, a boy, etc. She is used for females like your mother, any girl, your teacher if she is a lady. It is used for things and animals. Let us discuss some more examples. Number one, Shanti had a pen. Shanti has lost her pen. Shanti had a pen. She has lost it. In this sentence, the word she stands for Shanti and it stands for the pen. Number two, Gopal has bought a new car. Gopal likes the car. Now, let's see how can we use the pronoun. Gopal has bought a new car. Now, instead of Gopal, what we are writing? He. He likes it. The word he stands for Gopal and it stands for the car. Now, the third sentence. Puneet, Rohit and Sachin are good boys. Puneet, Rohit and Sachin are friends. So see how it is looking odd now, but we are repeating the names again and again. So let's see how we can make it make the sentence using pronouns. Puneet, Rohit and Sachin are good boys. They are friends. So the word they stands for Puneet, Rohit and Sachin. Number fourth, the boys are playing cricket. They are playing well. The word they stands for the boys. Number fifth, I am Satish. Give me this book. We use words I and me when we are referring to ourselves. Here, I and me stands for Satish. Number sixth, how are you? When we are talking to someone or asking a question, we address that person as you. Now, let us see something else. I, he, she, me, him, her, it, etc. are used for singular nouns. We, they, them, us are used for plural nouns. Now, you is a word which is used for both singular and plural nouns. For example, do you have a pet? Here, you is used for singular noun. Next example, it is a very important match. You all must play as a team. Here, you is used as a plural noun. Now, coming to next pronoun, that is we. We is used for many people, including you, that is the speaker. For example, we are going for a picnic. So in this we, the one who is saying is also going for the picnic. Now they. They is also used for many people but not including you or the speaker. It is the speaker is just saying that they are doing this but the speaker is not involved. For example, David and Tom are friends. Now instead of David and Tom, which pronoun we can use? They. So they are friends. Now let us understand the concept of pronouns more clearly through a short story. Once upon a time, There was a king. His name was John. He was very wise and kind. He had a son and a daughter. They were very good. The prince was very imaginative. He wanted to meet a fairy. One day, both of them were talking about their dreams. The prince said, "I am sure I will meet a fairy one day." The princess didn't believe in magic. She was more practical. So now you see that ma'am have underlined a few words. And what are these words? These are pronouns. Suppose we are using this pronoun he. So we have used the pronoun he for king. What was the name of the king? John. So we have mentioned his name. So the second time when we are going to say something about the king, we are using the pronoun he. Similarly, we have told about that this king had a son and a daughter. So for in the next sentence, we are using they because two are there. So we are going to use the pronoun they for them. Again, for the prince, we have used he. And here the prince is addressing himself. वो अपने बारे में हमको कुछ बता रहा है तो we have used the pronoun I. So I is for us. And for the princess, we have used the pronoun she. Now there is an assignment, an exercise for you to do. And I think you are going to enjoy doing it. What is the exercise? Rewrite the following sentences using a pronoun in place of nouns. So this is your home assignment and you are going to complete it, and so that you will be perfect with your pronouns. Bye.